Tonight's docket is in order. We are going to go through the warrant and the budget. And the mission of tonight is for FinCom to actually vote on all of those categories this evening. And then based on that information for the budget, FinCom then is actually presenting that budget to town meeting. And as it relates to the warrant, all the information goes through the process, and the vote of FinCom, the vote of the other groups, are all taken and recorded on the warrant that actually goes out. So we're going to do the warrant articles first. Anybody else? I don't think there's an issue.
Okay.
No, we're good.
Mark, okay. If I might just ask, there's a sign-in sheet going around, if everyone would make sure to sign in. Thanks, Mark.
Great. So procedurally, what we're going to do is we're going to walk through all of the warrant articles that have financial implications, and we'll take a vote on each one of those. The first article is Article 2, and that actually is just kind of highlighting that there will be a report that's given to town meeting. Different groups do it. It starts out with the Board of Selectmen. FinCom will be there as well, and then there are a series of other updates. The next article then is going to be Article 4, which is amendments to the Fiscal 16 Capital Improvement Program. Bob, can I hand it over to you?
Sure. Just to be clear, it's actually amendments to the 10-year capital plan, or 11 if
16
you
to 26. Thank you.
Bond Council says we explicitly must list in a format like is behind you the current year and the next year. So 16 and 17 must be shown fully. And then any years beyond, you just can say something like that. And then there's obviously an Excel spreadsheet that lists all the details. This is, as you saw it a few weeks back, there's a small reduction in FY16. Primarily, there's some things moving around within the facilities department, and there is a need for a new dump truck. And then FY17, there's a reduction. In FY16, there's really nothing in water and sewer for the rest of the year. But there is some moving around in FY17.
Okay, FinCom, any comments, questions on subject in Article 4? So this is exactly as we saw it 3 weeks ago, I think.
I think the only change...
No, slight change, sorry.
There might be a slight change in police and fire station carpeting. And there might be a reduction in fire station technology to pay for it. Those kind of ring a bell. There's not a net change of any consequence, though.
Yeah, so we were at...
It might have been...
No net change before, right?
Yeah. Now there's a minus $50,000 and a plus $35,000 that get added in.
Okay, think of any discussion? Questions? No? All good? Are we ready to take a vote?
Do we need a formal motion?
No, we need...
I'll make a motion to accept Article 4 as written.
We have a second?
A second.
Any further discussion? All those in favor? Opposed? So we are 8-0-0.
Mark, you want to assign the report?
Yeah, let's definitely do that tonight. So our goal is going to be to kind of spread around to have everybody have an opportunity. I think we're going to have enough articles for that this time. So does someone want to volunteer, or do you want me to allocate?
I'll go first.
Mark, you're up. All right, and let's go to Article 5, amending 16.
The only changes I can recall, and there might be a few of those, There's the use of some surplus snow and ice money that 2 weeks ago I dared it to snow and it did, but it wasn't enough.
All good. All good.
So there. So there's right here $32,500 of surplus. Right, as of this morning, there's about $115,000 still in the account. So this is, we can still stand one good storm.
Which we will have.
Yes, which we will have, no doubt.
No.
This coming Sunday. And I don't remember if there's anything else that's changed. It might be a couple thousand dollars one way or the other. I don't think there's the capital changed by that $15,000. I don't think there's anything else.
Got it. So the economic development planner was in at 15 and now it's at 10?
Yeah, we decided that timing-wise, we weren't about to do anything until town meeting ended. So the chances of us actually hiring someone in May are about zero. So this is well more than a month's salary at $10,000. And just to be clear, if we do not use $10,000 or some portion of it, that closes to free cash. So it comes out of the revolving fund and ends up in free cash, which is why you wouldn't want to just put a big number out there, just in case.
Okay, and we had snow and ice. Oh, sorry, no, there was nothing there before.
Right. Yeah.
Went 0 to 32.5.
So the net of this is 0 from free cash, which is interesting. I don't remember that happening. And then just $10,000 from the inspections revolving fund.
Comments, questions, FinCom? Good. Okay. Entertain a motion, please.
I make a motion to accept Article 5 as written.
Second.
Further discussion? None appearing. All those in favor? Opposed? Here 800. Who would like to take this one?
I can go.
All right, David, you're on.
I'm sorry, who did you say for Article 4 and 5? For
Mark reports? Is going to take 4.
Okay.
And David will take
Thank you.
5. Okay, Article 6, funding OPEB.
We've done this for, I think it's the fourth and fifth year in a row. Some years when we've had surplus in health insurance, we have used additional contributions. We actually do have that this year. We just used 130,000-odd in the prior article to balance. It's a philosophical question whether you put more into this, but I think we should at least put in the budgeted amount. And again, the budgeted amount for water and sewer and stormwater are funding it in, is it 20 years, Sharon, or 30?
OPEB,
there's enterprise funds.
I think it's 18.
So it's 20 years, so it's 18 left. The general fund, we're funding somewhere between a quarter, a third of what an annual payment would be to be on that schedule. And the theory behind it has been when the pension is caught up on in FY29 or whatever that is, that this would kick in. It could well be that we're required to start funding OPEB faster than that at a higher rate, or we'll, if not just required, we'll suffer a ratings difficulty. But there's no immediate threat of that, certainly.
So the total here is $576,000, 500 general
yes.
fund, 50 water, 20 sewer, and 6 stormwater. In the last 2 years, we've done between 450 and 500?
Yes. And I think next year it's just level at 500.
I can always wait sort of the year before we move into irrevocable. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's a good way to do that because if we had a difficulty during the year on anything really, but health insurance in particular, you've got some money set aside. Mm-hmm. You're not obligated to put it in until you do this at town meeting.
Okay, any further discussion on 6? All good. Okay. Can I have a motion, please?
Motion to accept Article 6 as written.
And a second?
Second.
Great. Any discussion? Nope. Appearing? Okay. All in favor? Opposed? We are 800.
I'll take it.
Great. Okay, Ann, thank you. Just to walk backward for one second, I know that we've already gone through Article 5, but just so everyone is clear on that one also, part of that discussion was the first-year funding for the new K through 12 science curriculum materials for $150. So we now have approved that, which will have an implication on the budget discussion in a few minutes also.
If I might, also, I didn't explicitly mention it, but you also approved $70,000 out of water reserves for a couple of expenses that were listed. They're behind you if you need to see them. Those were things that the department deemed they preferred having in May rather than wait till July even.
Hydrants for new water mains, great. Okay, so we're set with six. Next is eight, Affordable Housing Trust Fund Allocation Plan.
That continues the thing that's gone on quite a while. Reading set up a housing production plan, or Reading set up a housing trust fund sooner than most communities, and thus very differently compared to most communities. The state has since created a model that most communities follow. We hired a consultant who came to the Board of Selectmen going on 3 or 4 years ago at least. Oh, here it is, April 2013, that suggested we change to the state model. The Selectmen thought it was fine the way it is, so it's stayed the way it is. The main difference would be if you went to the state's setup, you have a separate board of directors. Right now, that board of directors is a joint meeting of the Selectmen and the Housing Authority. So really not a huge difference, because probably those two boards would comprise board of directors. So this is the plan that is just, because it's not following the state model, it needs to be renewed every year. And there's $260,000, with $175,000 of future deposits from the memory care place up on Main Street over the next 5 years due in.
Is that for what place?
The old greenhouse place, the memory care.
Did we actually spend the $200,000 with Oak Tree?
They did.
They, so we let them use that? Okay. So there's $261,000 left. So I guess the only question on this one from my perspective is, it would be good to have some kind of a plan in terms of how we might use this to actually do what it's set up to do. And I don't know if that relates to current possible things coming into town or not, but it'd be great to find a way to have this do what it's supposed to.
And another possible use, if things got so tight that you're worried about $5,000 or $10,000, we are part of a regional housing group, regionalized housing person, with three other communities. We could draw from this fund to pay a portion of that person's salary. Right here, there's 5% up to a maximum of $10,000. You know, we're not quite in that desperate shape yet.
Did the MAPC plan address this at all in terms of affordable housing and possible support?
It's such a small amount with no revenue, no constant revenue going in that, you know, it's hard to spend a whole lot of time planning. You know, you might find a single use for it, but not really much of a plan. Now, the plan would be how to get regular revenue into it. And some communities, certainly the ones that have this Community Preservation Act, that's how they fund it. Is they put a certain amount of it into a fund such as this every year.
Barry, can I ask you a question? Do you know, as the Selectmen are starting to go through different options and possibilities, is a discussion of CPA something that might hit the docket just for a discussion?
We haven't brought it up recently, as far as I know. As you recall, I think it went to the voters 7 years ago?
10 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
Geez, 10 years. And it lost by...
Not a lot.
Like a few votes. And right. Boston's now talking about doing it. Lexington did it, and Lexington used it to rebuild the Carey Center, which is now a performing arts center that brings tons of revenue to the town. So, you know, other opportunities that we could use it for, sure. But I think, given the fact that we're going to be discussing this year an override, which is already going to, just to our operating budget, we've already had the library debt exclusion, which has hit people's pocketbooks this year. You know, adding a 1%, you know, I think that's something that, you know, I call it a great to have. But it, you know, it's either that or, you know, teachers, firemen, and police. I think I offer the teachers, firemen, and police. So,
yeah.
But it's, yeah, I mean, it's maybe one day.
Yeah. It might just be a topic that's worthy of, as we're kind of looking at all the potential sources and uses, mm-hmm. something that could, you know, just that it has been considered, here's the thinking, and here's the reasoning why, you know, not now, yes, no.
I think, I'm just talking for myself, not for the whole board, but I just think in terms of the bandwidth that we have,
right.
in terms of, you know, and all the things we're asking residents to do, I don't see this coming up in the next year. It's myself personally, maybe two, but certainly, yeah, I mean, if we had done it 10 years ago, I don't know how much we would have generated in revenue. And we could have probably used it for seeding a whole lot of community development projects, you know, affordable housing projects, you know, our own sort of performing arts center that we've been talking about in town for a long time. So, you know, that's water under the bridge
yep,
right now.
Yep.
But, yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of second on the list with a lot of other seconds on the list
yeah.
right now.
Exactly.
Okay, sorry, any other questions? Didn't mean to hog that. No. Okay, any other, can we get a motion under this article, please?
Motion to approve Article 8 as written.
Have a second?
Second.
Thank you. Any other comments? No. All right, let's take a vote. All those in favor? Opposed?
No, I'm recusing myself from this one.
Okay. So we are 7-0-1. And other than Craig, who would like to bring this one up? Okay, revolving funds, Article 9.
This is another one that comes up every year. There are two descriptive changes in the inspection revolving fund, just adding the word explicitly planning. The economic development planner really could be fit under the term general management, but it seems more transparent to do that. And then changing the spending authority in the Matera cabin to the facilities director because now that structure is in his budget. That's nothing else changed.
Great. Okay, FinCom, any discussion? Quiet.
I know.
Okay, I'll entertain a motion, please.
I move to approve Article 9 as written.
Second.
Second.
We got one down there.
Thank you.
Any other comments? No. Nope. Let's take a vote. All those in favor? And opposed? We are 8-0-0.
I'll take this one.
Thank you, Paula. Okay.
My favorite's the next one.
maybe we can get two. Article 10, disposal of surplus tangible property. We find any new items, or are we the same as we were?
It's the same. Got the right list, Jane, wherever you are.
Oops. So my Article 10 is looking different.
Yeah,
no, that's not the right one.
That's not the right one. Interesting.
Mine starts out with a truck number 8 valued at $20,000. It runs but has a crack frame.
This one question?
The one up on the screen might have been. Yeah, we had a technical difficulty somewhere. The one that's in front of you a couple weeks ago is the right one, if that's worth. That's why I just asked Jane.
That's all that happens, yeah.
And the one he's recently distributed, that was correct.
Do you have the new, the old?
Yeah.
Which is that?
So this is from our last review of meeting of March 9th.
Yeah, I'm just going to get the...
Yeah, it's actually quite different.
Yeah, I think what's in front of you, or what I just showed you, was last year's.
Oh.
That's why I checked.
Page 20, I think.
This is what went to the selectmen to vote, and this hopefully is, whoops, is accurate. Yeah,
yep.
That should be the one you're voting on.
15531123456780.
I think that's what went out to you over the weekend. I hope.
And then 18. Okay, yeah, this is the one that we saw last time.
Yeah.
Which is this last year's.
So you want to take a look on the screen. It's on the right one. Okay, any discussion, questions? No, all good. Someone want to make a motion under Article 10, please?
Make a motion to accept Article 10 as written.
Second.
Thank you. Any discussion?
The right way to phrase this is that the Board of Selectmen will be disposing of this, not or their delegates or something like that. Because I don't know when the Board of Selectmen actually does it, but...
they don't dispose of this.
Yeah, so shouldn't it be what your delegates or?
Oh, okay. This one's it?
Yeah.
Well, what was the first one that I had then?
Maybe it's not like this. Yeah,
this is what it's there.
No way to solve this then.
This is also like the ones I presented last year. Because I remember there being
the
police cars and that.
There's always police cars. You can just skip this one.
No, that's not one.
You could vote at the night of town.
Yeah, I think that's what we better do.
Better to. I thought the one that I showed you was the right one, but let's go back
the,
to it.
The smaller one?
No,
it didn't have.
There are four police vehicles.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I think this is the right one because this is the actual warrant that I'm working off of.
Yeah. Okay.
So cars 11 and 14 show up on both years' lists as 2011 Fords.
Couldn't get rid of it last year.
That's actually possible.
A lot newer than my cars.
You can either vote on what you see behind you, because that's what I would have said was right. And then if it's not right, I'll fix it on town meeting floor, or if you meet before.
You get them.
So this is the one I printed.
So that is the one that came in the package that he sent.
Yeah, we think this is the right one.
For the end of the day.
Okay, I'll make a new motion to accept.
No, that's the one you made the motion.
Okay.
Actually, that is the one.
That's the one that I showed you originally. People didn't believe me.
So I think the only
I'm
thing...
I'm sure you'll change the date on when we're voting.
Yeah.
Now that we've changed the meeting date.
So sorry, we have a motion and a second? We do. Okay, so then the question I'd like to bring up is why the same cars show up on last year's and this year's list, just to see if it's in fact that it wasn't sold and therefore it's back.
It may not be. I think the years of those cars are different.
Yeah, I was just going to say, just because it's car number something, that a new car might be named that.
No, it's the same year as well.
Is it okay?
It's 2011
same cars.
Number 14 and 2011 number 14 and 2011 number 11 and 2011 number 11.
Yeah, do we not trade them in?
Is that Blanche for me? I think I can tell you we still have those four cars. I'm trying to get rid of them today.
Got
what
it.
Happened last last year.
Well, they might have been cleared surplus. We didn't need to do it again, I suppose.
Got it. Okay, that's fine. I just wanted to make sure we don't have new cars coming in.
The past chief, though. It was either
that. You're going to run out of runway and do that.
Well, it could have been the former town manager's fault, but I think I brought that up.
See how many years they've been on the list. Okay, any other questions, comments? Nope, ready for a vote. Okay, all those in favor? And opposed? Sorry, are you, your vote for or against?
Yep, no, four.
Four, okay, we are 800 on this list. And Paula, since you love this one so much, let's just see, do we have enough articles to make that happen? Ooh, we don't actually. Sorry. But you want to swap Article 9?
I can take this one.
Okay. Vanessa will take this one. Okay. Article 11.
That requires a 9/10 vote by town meeting. It's a prior year's bill. We've gone over to vendor, tried to slip in a prior year's bill and a current invoice, and didn't really think it mattered, but it kind of does matter.
So this is for a copier lease.
Yeah, we have a lot of leases. The question we asked ourselves was, is there a way we're supposed to keep track of all the bills we're supposed to pay? And then when it doesn't come in, that we know. It's kind of hard, because it's not like we didn't pay one, we did, but we didn't necessarily itemize all the different line items. This is just one machine, so I don't know, it's an open question.
So instead of it coming in by June, it showed up in December?
Right. They just forgot to bill us in April, and then didn't catch up till several months later. And that happens occasionally. And most businesses are on a calendar year, so as long as they do it by December or whenever they do it, they generally don't care.
Any discussion on this one? No? All good? All right, I'll look to the right side. Somebody on the right side make a motion.
And just to be clear, the source of this would be free cash.
Motion.
I said to say
Article 11 is written.
Second.
Great, thank you. Any other discussion? At Bob's point, this is out of free cash, $328.65. Okay, let's take a vote. All those in favor? Opposed? We are 800.
I don't know if you just want to jump to Article 13 and skip the budget just to finish this off.
Yeah, let's
do chapter that. 90 on funds.
Let's assign somebody for
Article 11.
Okay, Greg, you got it. Okay, so let's go to 13, Chapter 90 funds.
Representative Jones was here last night, actually upstairs, and he indicated that Chapter 90 will actually get done pretty soon, and it'll be about the same as last year, plus or minus a few thousand, so $600,000 range is correct. The motion, if it's not a final number, will just be whatever the state gives us on the town meeting floor.
I certainly had a discussion a year or two ago that we could make a motion to accept the Chapter 90.
That's what we'll do. Is we'll just we'll put the number as background, but we won't put it in the motion because you never know what it's exactly going to be. It's probably not going to be known. Well, 50-50, it's known by town meeting. Mm-hmm. So it's better to, it doesn't really matter. It's not like you're not going to take it.
Right.
So whatever it is, we'll just accept. And there's some thinking out there in the legal community, you don't even have to do this, but we think it's better to do it.
Questions, comments? No? Okay. Move to my right side again for a motion, please.
Motion accept Article 13 as written.
Second.
Discussion, comments?
No.
All those in favor? Opposed? We are 800. And who would like Article 13? Who does not have an article yet?
Nobody has one?
I think so.
Oh, my gosh.
Who's not here?
Yeah.
Paul.
Paul gets it. Yeah. Paul's not here. Yeah.
Which okay.
Oh, Peter. Okay, and then That's the last one, correct? Okay, so now we can circle back to the budget. Article 12. So procedurally, we're going to go through each line item and have a separate vote on each line item. On the town side, there are a series of different budget numbers. On the school side, it's one single number. And I've confirmed, I'm just going to ask John, the number that we have here of $40,697,666.
That's the, probably the town manager's number, so that's that would be accurate.
Right.
Since you just voted on Article 5.
Got it. Okay, so the numbers as published here, I think, are correct.
No.
Okay, so we'll take them from the top. We'll start with B99.
I make a motion to accept line item B99 benefits in the amount of $15,988,500.
Have a second?
Second.
Just so everyone is understanding kind of how this process is moving so quickly this evening, we've all seen all these numbers, had discussions about all these numbers, have reviewed them in some detail. And so at this point, it's any lingering questions, comments, or other things that are brought up that would inspire us to make any changes. So I apologize if it seems like we're going through it very quickly. I can assure you that's not how we did it. So we have a second on that one. So any discussion on the benefits number? Nope. All right. Let's take a vote. All those in favor? Opposed? Here, 800. C99 capital. How about we speed it? Vanessa, can we start with you? We're just going to go kind of, you do the next one, then we'll go right down the line.
C99 capital in the amount of $2,070,000.
Second.
Discussion? All those in favor? Opposed? 800.
Motion to approve D99 debt service in the amount of $4,900,000.
Second.
Discussion. All those in favor?
Opposed?
800.
Motion to accept line item E99, educational vocational, in the amount of $384,350.
If I might interject, superintendent sent me an email a couple of weeks ago. There's a couple more students that may apply to the vocational schools in the fall. If they do and they're accepted, we may need to bump this number at town meeting, but we won't know. Honestly, we might not even know in November. We might have to wait till April, but just so you're aware of that.
Yeah, I don't see any reason to use the number in here. Let's just wait. Any other comments on this one? Nope. All right, let's take a vote. All those in favor? Opposed? 800.
I gotta look over that. Motion to approve line item F99, Finance Committee Reserve, in the amount of $150,000.
Second.
Thank you. Questions, comments? All those in favor? Opposed? 800.
This year there's 225. Oh, that's
one. Alright, David, can you use G91?
Sure. Motion to approve line number G91, administrative service wages, in the amount of $1,431,140.
Second.
Discussion. Nope, all good. All those in favor?
Opposed?
800. Mark, can I do G92?
Sure. Motion to approve line item G92, administrative services expenses, in the amount of $1,332,900.
Second.
Thank you. Discussion? Not appearing. All those in favor?
Opposed?
800.
Motion to approve line item H92, public service.
H91?
91.
Excuse me. No, I'm sorry, skip the line. H91, public services wages, the amount of $1,253,375.
Second. Discussion. Take a vote. All those in favor?
Opposed?
0-0.
Wait, H92?
Yes, please.
Motion to approve line item H92, public services expenses, in the amount of $367,750. Second.
Discussion. Okay, let's take a vote. All those in favor? Opposed? 8-0.
Motion to approve line item I-91, finance wages, in the amount of $634,550. Second.
Discussion. Okay, ready for a vote. All those in favor?
Opposed?
8-0-0.
Motion to accept line item I-92, finance expenses, in the amount of $146,750. Second.
Discussion. Ready to take a vote. All those in favor?
Opposed?
8-0-0. Boy, Bob, am I happy we're not doing this on roll call?
I know.
Motion to approve line item J91, public safety wages, in the amount of $9,500,350.
Second.
Discussion. All those in favor? Opposed? Motion is 8-0-0.
Motion to approve line number J92, public safety expenses, in the amount of $453,000.
Second.
Thank you. Discussion. All those in favor?
Opposed?
8-0-0.
Motion to approve line item K91, public works wages, in the amount of $2,478,605.
Second.
Thank you. Discussion. All those in favor?
Opposed?
8-0-0.
Motion to accept line item K92, public works expenses, in the amount of $871,050.
Second, please.
Second.
Thank you. Discussion. No. Vote. All those in favor? Opposed? 0-0.
Motion to accept line item K93, works, snow and ice, in the amount of $625,000. Second.
Discussion. Hopefully that's way too much again.
No, that's, I'm thinking, hopefully you don't need it.
No other discussion. Great. Okay, let's take a vote. All those in favor? Opposed? 8-0-0.
Motion to approve line item K94, public works street lights, in the amount of $180,000. Second.
Discussion. Nope. Let's take a vote. All those in favor?
Opposed?
8-0-0.
Motion to accept line item K95, public works rubbish, in the amount of $1,450,000.
Second.
Thank you. Discussion.
As I think I mentioned a couple weeks ago, we haven't signed a contract yet, but I do expect this number to go up at November town meeting, and we'll probably be signing, I'm hoping, a 10-year contract that's not bad after that first year increase.
But you're not suggesting we change this number at all at this point, right?
I don't think so. We haven't signed it yet, so we don't know.
Right. Further discussion? No. Let's take a vote. All those in favor?
Opposed?
8-0-0.
Motion to approve line item L91, library wages, in the amount of $1,168,175.
Second.
Discussion. Nope. Let's take a vote. All those in favor? Opposed? 800.
Motion to approve line number L92 library expenses in the amount of $317,325.
Second.
Discussion. All right, take a vote. All those in favor?
Opposed?
800.
Motion to approve line item M91 court facilities in the amount of $2,853,790.
Second.
Thank you. Discussion. Hearing. Let's have a vote. All those in favor? Opposed? 800.
Motion to approve line item M92, town buildings, in the amount of $286,890.
Second.
Thank you. Discussion? Nope. Any? Let's take a vote. All those in favor?
Opposed?
800.
Motion to approve line item U99, school department, amount of $40,600,000. $697,666.
Second.
Discussion. Up hearing. Take a vote. All those in favor?
Opposed?
800.
Motion to approve line item W99, Water Enterprise Fund, in the amount of $6,240,274.
Second.
Thank you. Discussion. Not appearing. Take a vote. All those in favor?
Opposed?
800.
Motion to accept line item X99 Sewer Enterprise Fund in the amount of $5,706,390.
Second.
Discussion?
Nope.
Take the vote. All those in favor?
Opposed?
800.
Motion to approve line item Y99 Stormwater Enterprise Fund, the amount of $530,430.
Second.
Thank you. Discussion. Okay, we'll take a vote. All those in favor?
Opposed?
800. Wow.
New record.
Yeah. It's at least an hour faster than what it was.
Well, I think a lot of it is a result of great preparation and attending a lot of the meetings. Mm-hmm. It made a big difference.
For sure. Yes,
you're really able to ask questions, get them answered. So nice job on that. I think, just as a quick comment, I think that in the past meetings we discussed possible adjustments to these numbers, and I'll speak for myself, not for the whole group, but it was my feeling that we weren't really in a position to do that this year, that things are balanced and appropriate, and a number of things we couldn't do, but that's where we are.
Agreed.
Any other business here before we go through minutes?
No.
Good. Everybody, thank you very much. You're welcome to stay for our minutes.
This was a lot of feeding than I did this last year. So this was a lot sweeter than I did last year.
That's probably the right one. Let's ask Bob the question.
What's that?
There may be a discrepancy in a number of the public service wages. I'm sorry, the public safety wages, right?
Yeah.
Bob, can I ask you a question? Yeah. We're checking line J91. And here is $9,500,350.
Yeah, I did too.
On the sheet.
It was 9953, I think. I'm trying to get back to it.
On my thing, it's 950,350. I think that's what someone said. What's the other number you have?
It was a higher number. Let me pull up here.
The total budget of the department is 9953,350.
Right. Yeah, so how do we trace it back?
And the expenses.
The wages and the expenses.
That's the total. Okay, but
953,351.
Got it, okay.
So let's make sure that that's...
Let me pull it back.
It looks all right in this version here, too.
Yeah, it's kind of what was presented. The screen behind you, I was kind of following along with the UNIS budget, and the numbers seemed to tie in.
We were following along with this one, and
that's
okay.
Right. Yeah. Oh, you were right.
Yeah, it looks
time.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great.
Okay. My binder from last week.
Where was that version from? I wonder.
Does this February 17th?
Yeah. It seems to work.
I thought.
We'll just make sure that that's what it is.
I think it's
the exact number, so it probably is, but let's see how it's done.
We take another final look just before town meeting votes just to make sure, because certainly addition errors do happen.
Yeah.
Especially when you do numerical.
So you're saying this 453 is included in that?
Yes. That's the total. And then actually scroll down. Let's see if it shows wages. There you go.
There it is. Okay. Okay.
And does it 9500?
Yeah, it is.
Okay.
Yeah. False alarm. Just testing.
Those are the best ones. Okay. Let's go through the March 2nd minutes.
I'll make a motion to accept the minutes of March 2nd.
I wanted to just my last name is, you could either do Ann Johnson Lambie or Ann Lambie, but probably just Ann Johnson. It doesn't quite work.
So we need actually a second. We get a second?
Second.
Thank you. Okay, now we'll make that change. Any other comments or changes we need in this one? See your hand. Opposed?
It's all about your name, right?
0-0. Yeah, sorry. Whoops. Let's go to 3-9. Wrote the wrong thing down.
Before I mention question or
yeah, I think we're supposed to put it into the
right, that's it.
Opening first and then discuss
it every year.
So you want to make a motion to
sure, I'll make a motion to accept the minutes of March 9th.
Second. All right.
And then I did have a question on the bottom of page 3. The sensitive to the word layout. I wasn't sure what. So noted that publicized was gone into the roads. We have to put into perspective layoff, but still paved roads. I'm not sure.
This was Paul. I wasn't here.
I'm trying to think what.
Yeah, let's
just a quick catch. We have to put it into perspective.
That's available. How about if we just cross all that out then from layoff to the end?
Yeah.
Does that work?
Yeah. Anymore. Yeah.
Anymore. Period. All the other stuff disappears. Oops, sorry. I'm negligent. Need more time on this one, or we're all set? We're good? All right, let's take a vote. All those in favor?
Opposed?
We're good. Oh, that's the right thing to say. All right, now go to 316. Question came when there are other committees that are present, like the school committee was there.
Yep.
Should we not list them under other present?
Can we vote?
So what I do when there's present, I do everyone that signed in on the sign-in sheet. So if they didn't sign in,
then they weren't present.
in the minutes I think there, but if they didn't sign in,
I'm wondering if we want to put them in.
Just the people who spoke.
Because probably, I think what's going on is that the school committee won't report. They won't take minutes from a meeting that they just attended. That they weren't participating
in. Right, if they
had
called the order, then
we... But they were in attendance. Oh, you're right. It doesn't say they're called the order. Can we just check that?
Yes.
If they did or didn't. If they did, I think we should put them in. And if not, then. Sorry, I just went out of order on that one.
I'm wondering if we can. Well, it sounds like we need to check into it anyway, but I wasn't sure if we could vote on this meeting, the minutes from the 16th, since they weren't on our agenda.
Right, they weren't on the agenda, meaning.
Meaning,
oh, because
they're not, oh, they weren't noticed, or it's not part of the notice that went out.
So, perfect timing. Yeah, I think actually.
You look at the bottom of the agenda,
yeah.
Pay no attention to what else is
written out. Okay. Reasonable anticipation of discussion at the meeting.
Behind the curtain.
Very good. Very good.
I guess I would suggest that we hold this for our next meeting just to understand what we need to do about the school committee.
Okay.
If not, we're not sure if they were called to work for that meeting.
Last week?
2 weeks ago. Yeah. Yeah, I think we can ask them. Let's just check. Let's see what it is.
I was there.
I think
they kind of drifted then. That's
yeah. Signed up the sign-in sheet.
Okay. Yeah. Chuck was there. Gene was there.
Linda was there.
I don't remember about Gary.
I just don't remember.
I think there was a quorum, but
I think I remember them.
They weren't all there at once.
Yeah. Elaine came late. That's right.
Late.
Yeah. So yeah, I think they had a quorum.
You better wait.
I'm pretty sure they did.
Okay.
So let's hold that one in advance.
I can email John and ask him the question.
Okay. Okay, a couple of the quick items. We put ourselves for one more meeting before town meeting. Did we do that?
Yeah.
What is that? So before town meeting, we had scheduled ourselves for another meeting, which is 13th. So there were a couple of things we were going to do on the 13th, I think. One was if there are any new items that came up that we were going to vote before town meeting. And I think the other question was related to materials, the factual materials and things that we had talked about.
Hmm.
So I think we're not quite ready to do that. Is my take on it. I think that we're better off working collectively with the other groups. I also think that Bob's piece that he put out initially is a good one to use as a starting point. I still am getting requests from citizens asking for the factual materials, however. So I'm not sure how to address that. Any thoughts?
Well, don't we have to provide materials that have been reviewed at the meeting?
So Bob's published his. The minutes of the selectman meeting will have what was there. The minutes of our meetings will have ours. The difference is, I think we had talked about putting together some fact sheets. And then my take, and this is a good discussion, my take after the selectman's meeting at town council was that there is an opportunity to put together materials. However, the distribution of those materials is a different story.
Right.
Right.
But we always should, when it's requested of us, provide those materials when they're requested of us, but we should not disseminate them proactively unless it's in a place that every member of the community may also.
Can everybody post to the same place?
Right. If everyone could post on the website, then we could, but otherwise, no.
Right. So I guess the question is, what materials are we talking about?
What has been requested?
Just for your background, in early April, the plan is we have a new website being launched. We'll see.
Yay.
Actually, the assessors have volunteered of being the repository for all factual information, since that sort of makes sense. So they're going to have a page in the assessing division. I don't know what we'll call it, but it's information surrounding the override. So there'll be one solid location that'll be easy to find from the front page. And then the question is, what do you put there? And obviously, we're going to want input from you folks. So the things that have already been discussed and shown in public meetings will go there automatically, even though they may also be part of minutes or other things. But I think what you're talking about are things that really aren't compiled yet. Maybe conceptually they are, or maybe they've been done in the past, but the current new version may not have been yet. Last week at the selectmen's meeting, Barry was not there. The three selectmen discussed the process, and they agreed for two more selectmen's meetings through April not to discuss any of this, as those other agenda items, but in May to return and discuss it. But one thing they decided, since there was three of them there, they could, which was really helpful, was the information meetings that are proposed for mid to late May and June will not include a vote of the selectmen with a number. So they intend to present factual information. They may or may not present opinions, that's up to them. But they very loudly want to listen to the community as to what the concerns out there are. And there's no sense in them telling the community what they should vote for until they listen to the community. So the listening will go on for that 3, 4, 5, 6 weeks. And then over the summer, they'll have it probably on several agendas. They'll toss it all around, they'll vote something. And once they've voted something, then they'll have another series of meetings, possibly in late August, but certainly in September, especially ahead of a town meeting, to describe what we concluded. This is what you said, this is what we showed you, this is what you said, this is about how we're solving the problem, just so you're all aware of that kind of background. So while there is a need for factual information in the next month, it's not a complex solution that's needed, just so you're clear.
Yeah, no, thank you. I think what we had talked about was more background information, as opposed to saying, here's therefore. It's more the background. So the requests I've been receiving, one of them actually by email and phone today, was history and factual information, kind of on where we are, what 18 is likely to look like from a budget point of view, kind of everything that would lead up to a discussion of what's next.
You could just probably refer them to the
the website ought
to do. To the the budget presentation, which I think sort of lays out what the next year is going to look like.
Sorry, when I say next year, I'm talking about 18. Sorry, the fiscal 18 budget.
Yeah, but didn't we have that?
Well, it's in very loose terms.
Sort of an assumption of 1%.
It's like a less than 1% budget.
Right. So the discussion I had today was related to other discussions, so much hearsay, et cetera, but just saying, hey, where are we? What are the facts? What is 18 going to look like at this point? And I'm starting to ask for what are the options, but I appreciate the position of let's show people, let's listen, let's see what they have to say.
And just as a slight update, we got the final inflation data out of Washington for their RMLD payment, and it's very small increase next year. It's 0.6%.
So the
RMLD $2.5 million, I'll call it owner's dividend. We had budgeted at 2% because as of October, November, that was the annual rate of inflation in Boston, Brockton, Nashua. It ended up at 0.6% because energy prices dropped so much over the winter. So that's a $50,000 difference or so, some number. And that doesn't sound like a lot of money, but that drops you a couple tenths of a percent in operating budgets, or not quite. So we're around 0.7 for FY18 right now, using $2 million of free cash. And the RMLD longer-term number is between 1 and 2% now for 5 and 10 years. So the CPI is, if anyone's in the field of economics, CPI is a lousy measure if you're trying to make money. You know, it's a biased number to begin with.
Over the last 10 years, yeah.
Yeah. Doesn't capture the black market and technology in general.
Right. Right. So, bottom line, that 1% estimate might even be a little bit rosy.
So I think that in the future, we're going to be a lot more careful on the RMLD number, because even though it doesn't seem to be a big deal, you know, 50,000 is still 50,000, or could be worse. Yeah, the forecast for the next 3 years is certainly well under 1% each year in aggregate, and that's using a good amount of free cash.
On the other request, I think you got that email too, was about tax rate, but I actually think that's a really selectman kind of information. Tax
rates?
Yeah, tax rate versus
That's
residential versus.
Oh, kind of doing a classified.
What's that?
We mean potentially splitting the tax rate.
So I think it's really best for the selectmen.
Do you think probably pointing to that budget presentation that talks about the 1% would be responsive to that individual's question? And we don't have the ability on Finance Committee, just if he's looking for what specific services would be cut, you know, or, you know, we don't have the capacity to answer that question.
I don't know that anybody does.
Think it seems that the presentation would be responsive.
So, Bob, is the presentation you gave to the selectmen, is that actually up on the website now too?
So it's on the homepage.
On the homepage,
yeah.
So, like, for example, this person who requested it can certainly direct them to that. It's public now up on the website. So maybe my gut is we start with that, in which case I'm not sure we need to meet in April, you know, unless something comes up that's...
Yeah, if it's certainly town meeting related, I'll absolutely let you know. I hope not.
What do you think, guys?
I agree. I think it needs a little more time to develop.
Okay, so should we leave the 13th on there as a placeholder or take it off?
I think you should leave it and just pretend you're going to meet and it's easy not to meet.
So that?
Here's an updated answer to your question. I'm struggling with my mouse here. Here's the next 3 years. At the top. And you can see that's using $2 million and then a little less free cash in the next couple of years. And, you know, one of the organized groups has asked for this specific document, and I said as soon as it's ready for town meeting, which it, as of yesterday afternoon it really was, I would send it out. This is a nice summary that looks backward a little and mostly forward.
Who'd you say was asking for that, Bob?
One of the groups that's formed over the override question.
Okay.
Did you also have a projected free cash position?
Not on this one.
So remember, we also talked about actuals. So going actuals on free cash. So project these amounts, but you keep telling me that we actually keep generating. And can we get those numbers? Are those?
Yeah, Sharon has all the history of free cash, both in graphic and table form. It's hard to project out.
Not project it out, but the actuals.
No, backwards was easy. Yeah, that's all a fact. I think that goes in the town meeting packet somewhere. I think it's under her section, actually, in revenues.
Yeah,
this mouse was behaving, I'd find it.
She basically, I think she showed it in a graph.
Yeah.
In actual.
Yeah. Let's see. I don't remember. Yeah, we should, we just request that from her. So I think the other part of it is the story of what we project the reserve position to be as we're pulling to 1.75 out of here. And the discussion we had last time also was that some of the areas where we're getting the replenishment, we're not feeling as good about right now, like excise.
We just used a lot at April, or we will ask to use a lot at April town meeting to balance budgets. So you know, that's not going to be regenerated. That's a certain amount that isn't anyways. As long as I keep saying there won't be any, there will, though. So there won't be any.
Good luck, Charm.
Okay, so let's, I think if we could ask Sharon for that, that's probably exactly what we should do here. Take a look at that free cash actual usage number.
Yeah.
See what that's looked like. Okay, so we'll leave the 13th on. Any other business questions? So whether or not we meet on the 13th, we'll have town meeting coming up. Usually what happens, no guarantee, is the first night is things other than budget, and then it's budget the next night. So we'll have to see how that goes. But who is a town meeting member at this point? Just to know. You are?
Yeah.
Phil Meyer.
I'm not sure.
How would I know?
It's on the website. We can find it. You would have got a letter.
You would have run for the office.
Say it again.
You would have run for the office.
I have not.
Okay. Or someone
I don't know. I volunteer for so many things without knowing what.
So there actually is a third option here too, which is that if your precinct has openings and you are interested in the slot, okay, then you'd want to go to the precinct meeting before town meeting starts.
Didn't they fill all the...
all the seats are filled, but some are ties and need to be resolved at the precinct meetings.
In every precinct?
There was lots of write-ins.
There were people that got, I can't remember, 10 or 12 votes as write-ins and they lost.
Wow.
Some people got...
It wasn't organized effort to write people in.
Yeah.
Aren't there several that are supposed to be removed?
There's some proposed, yeah.
How will that affect vacancies?
Like they remove them, they'll be vacant.
Yeah, it's usually at the end of town.
It won't be vacant until after that.
We wouldn't be able to request those until next one in November.
It's the last article.
Yeah, right.
Got it. Okay.
Yeah, it's a good reason to move that to November, but that's the way our charters says it to go.
Okay, anything else, guys? Mm-hmm.
No,
I would entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Do we have a second?
Second.
All those in favor? Opposed? We are adjourned. Thank you, guys.
No, I owe Kevin.